Well, favorite albums, of course, in the very beginning, there was the Beatles. You need to take in the Beatles into the account, and I think as far as the Beatles, many people talk about Sgt. Pepper as the sort of the big album that changed everything. For me personally, I think that the album before that one, Revolver, was probably the one that changed everything. For that band, it changed from being a pop group to being more like a, what can we do in the studio? How can we use the studio to make any kind of music, you know, anything from Yellow Submarine to whatever, I'm Only Sleeping to Tomorrow Never Knows. I think it was on that one. Correct me if I'm wrong. But all the backwards stuff, you know. I think that was sort of a pinnacle in the 60s when the Beatles made that one. Another one I remember was Jimi Hendrix, and I was into Jimi Hendrix from the start, you know, from the first album. But I think Electric Ladyland by Jimi Hendrix was another one that I think made a big impact, because they, Jimi and his engineer, Eddie Kramer, they made something that was more than presenting what Jimmy did on stage, you know. They pushed the studio to the limit, you know. So that was with stereo and everything. I remember me and a friend of mine, we were sitting listening to this Jimi Hendrix album, and we could hear the guitars moving from the right speaker to the left speaker, and that was fantastic back in the day, you know. This was a long time ago. And then, of course, you have Frank Zappa and the Mothers. You have Frank Zappa, and he did music. He did rock music that was many times based on rhythm and blues or blues. But also, he had his love for classical music and avant-garde, and he made all these crazy collages of, you know, sounds and very odd stuff, really, already before the 70s. So that's something that made an impact, even if I didn't, at the time I wasn't a huge fan, but I saw what Frank was doing and thinking, this is really interesting, this is pushing rock music forward in a completely different direction. And then of course you had King Crimson, who I think I heard the first time in 1969, the first album. And they were pushing in yet another direction, you know, with metal and classical and what you call progressive or symphonic rock. So that was sort of the start of progressive rock, together with Frank Zappa and the Beatles, of course. So it was an interesting time, and I was lucky enough to be around at the time, you know, and exploring all these great bands and you know, see the progressive rock scene explode at the time, around 67 until 75 or whatever, you know. So the question is, can you make progressive rock today? Well, you can. It's going to be, I think, nothing new really, you know, because they pushed it so far already, so there's not much you can do until it turns into something that no one want to listen to anyway, you know. So there's always going to be a melody, there's going to be a beat. People want to have a beat, a groove, something like that. But I still feel, you know, confident about doing progressive rock. And here's the dog, he's a little doggy. I feel confident about doing it and keep writing songs and be inspired by whatever, you know, be it progressive rock or jazz or pop songs or, you know. So that's where I am right now, and here's this new album, and it represents everything I learned from way back then until now, and we look into the future. Well, I have playing on this album Marco Miniman, who plays all the drums. I have playing the bass guitar, I have Jonas Reingold playing a few songs. I have Michael Stolt, my brother, playing on a few songs. And actually, I'm playing bass also on a couple of songs. I do have Hasse Fröberg from the Flower Kings singing a bit. I have Ned Sylvan singing some stuff. I have Rob Townsend playing the saxophone and the flute on one, two songs. And I play a bit, or quite a bit, of keyboards. Just like the first Flower King album, I play quite a bit of keyboards myself, because it's fun. But I have help from Max Lawrence playing the Hammond organ, and Zach Kamins playing the organ and the synthesizers. Okay, so go check out the new album. It's coming out on November the 3rd, I think, in Europe, possibly in America too. It's almost a full album of, well, 70 minutes, something like that, of brand new music, of course. And then go check out the band if you can in Europe in December, together with Spock's Beard, and in South America in mid-November. So hopefully see you there. Bye-bye.